Hello everyone, and welcome to one more episode of our AI conversation. I am your host, Ramiro Sanchez, Google CMO for Latin America. Today, we are bridging continents, connecting virtually with Doron Avni in Tel Aviv. He's Google Vice President of Government Affairs and Public Policy for the Emerging Markets region, which covers Africa, the Middle East, and of course our home, Latin America. He's going to share with us insights of how Latin America can harness artificial intelligence for economic growth, social impact, and responsible innovation. AI has a tremendous potential to help businesses thrive, create new job opportunities, and solve some of society's biggest challenges. Get ready for an insightful conversation. Hello, Doron, welcome.
Thanks for having me, Ramiro.
I love this painting hanging there in your background.
Yeah, this painting is amazing. We did this with Gemini, that's Google's generative AI model. And it's so easy these days to translate ideas into beautiful pictures like this one. We created this one just for the interview, but it's so nice that I think I'll keep you there.
That's certainly a unique touch and a great way for set the scene today that we are talking about AI. And Doron, you have been at the forefront of shaping Google policies and strategies in over 100 countries, engaging with governments on Google's agenda. And that's a huge overtaking. But today, let's zoom in on Latin America and the exciting possibilities that AI brings to this region of the world.
Yeah, look, absolutely. It's certainly an exciting time in around the world and in Latin America as well. And I think AI has the power to transform Latin America. We're talking about boosting industries, about really changing people's lives. If we're looking at the numbers, pretty exciting ones. Research has shown that AI can add up to 5.4% to Latin America GDP by 2030. And the good news is not, you know, in the far future. We're already seeing actual examples. One of the examples I like the most is a startup in Brazil called Tracto. And they're using cloud and AI to create custom ads by the thousands for their clients. And they're doing this in the blink of an eye. And I think there's a lot of great enthusiasm across the region, which I see everywhere I go when I travel across Latin America. So there's good enthusiasm to build on. In fact, research has shown that Latin Americans are significantly more optimistic about AI than many people in the West. So it's up to us to harness this optimism and take it forward.
What are the key recommendations you have for government and business leaders in the region?
Yeah, so we outlined this potential framework in a report that we called AI Sprinters, and it's centered around four pillars. The first is infrastructure, investing in infrastructure. Then comes people. Investing in people is equally important. Making sure that we enable technological innovation is super critical, and as well as making sure that we push for policies around the region that are hospitable and enabling AI. Ramiro, if you recall, it was back in 2022 where Sundar, our CEO, made a commitment to invest in Latin America $1.2 billion in 5 years. And a big piece of this commitment was investing in subsea cables and in data centers. And indeed, just a few weeks ago, we announced that we will be building a new data center in Uruguay, investing $850 million. But we're not stopping there. We also announced recently that we'll be expanding our engineering presence in Brazil, building a new engineering center in Sao Paulo. So you'll have Brazilian talented engineers working on top AI-enabled products for Google.
There is really no AI power without human power, right? What does that mean?
Yeah, certainly so. The second pillar of the AI Sprinters is all about people. And we want to make sure that we empower people with skills to build AI, to use AI, to innovate with AI. We want to promote AI for Latin America by Latin Americans, right? And in order to get there, we're doing a lot. So one thing that I'm really proud of is the investment we made in 1 million scholarships for Google Career Certificates. And we'll be deploying these 1 million scholarships by 2026. But when we talk about skills and people, I think it's more than just the professional development, right? It's also about people's transformation. One example that comes to mind is that I heard recently is a lady called Miriam in Brazil, a 53-year-old former teacher that during the pandemic felt that she's sort of at the crossroad in her life, and she wanted to think, you know, what's next for me? And she decided to take the Google course for UX design. And then she set up her own social media agency, and she's doing well. So it's really heartwarming that investing in people can really unlock so much human potential.
Absolutely. And people are indeed a key element in this journey of digitalization. But there is still a missing piece, right? I would guess that missing piece is data. Data is definitely one of the words I have heard the most in my conversation with business leaders across the region.
Yeah, Ramiro, that's true. And I will emphasize it's all about local data, right? It's really important to have local data, which is good quality and is accessible. And when you have this, you can unlock a lot of technological innovation. So for example, when we talk about AI, you can make local products which are more relevant and more effective in the local context. But in order to utilize data, you also need modern data laws, such laws that will allow sharing data, but at the same time will preserve privacy and security. So this can unlock great innovation. Take, for example, Google's green light project in Rio de Janeiro. We're taking real-time data from Google Maps, and with that data, we're optimizing traffic lights, the timing of traffic lights in Rio de Janeiro. And by doing that, we can reduce car stops by up to 30%, and we can reduce emissions at intersections by up to 10%. And not only that, you know, already more than 4 million people living in Rio de Janeiro enjoy better flow of cars every month because of this project.
So thank you, Doron. And this is super insightful. So I propose we stop here for today and we will come back to see how this can be applied for Latin America.
Thank you, Ramiro.
Thank you.